I'm just someone who saw it.
What do you mean saw it? Saw what?
Saw them take him.
You would have been...
I was seven. I was there when it happened. And I have proof.
Ladies, you play sisters. And oddly enough, on I don't see it so much right now, mm-hmm. but on the screen, there's a real similarity, which is crazy in my mind. But their characters couldn't be any more different.
Yes.
The liar, the one on edge.
The angel.
But you know, you understand her point of view because she's dealing with this constant fallout of lies and deception and high energy and weirdness. Like that looked really authentic. So what were you thinking?
Yeah, and the, like the intoxication of it all. That it, because it's really it's fun, and it's hard to resist someone who creates this world that's really fantastical. But it seems to be grounded. Like there's just enough facts that she maneuvers together to create this reality that Laura can be like, oh, and then she's like, yeah. This just like the level of excitement is it's hard to resist, and I think that's also emblematic of the younger sibling who can get really swept up and just has a natural tendency to be totally consumed by the older sister's world.
Yeah,
until it gets a little too intense.
It's incredible, but there's a moment there where you go. At the table, and I'm so with you. although I want to believe you.
Yeah, it is. I think it is. Like you say, it's very. It's kind of those people are often very charming, and there's a reason why people believe their lies and why they can get through life with a certain level of deception, and they keep repeating these cycles is because people allow them to do it because they are. That there's something about them, and they do it in a way which draws you in, and it's and I think. For the most part, they believe it themselves because they have to convince themselves in order to convince other people. So the levels of deception going on are so deep that it's often really hard for them to stop. And it's not malicious. It's just compulsive.
Compulsive, natural. And you think of businessmen and politicians and White House and all of that. And you see how it comes. And you really have to wonder if she actually saw what she thinks she saw.
Yeah.
And that's something...
Well, it's based on a real memory of Albert's, the director, and he says himself, it's become so warped in my mind that I don't remember exactly what I saw anymore. I know that I think I saw someone being bundled into the boot of the car, and I think it was this young boy, but I don't, the more you tell the story, the more you embellish it, and it becomes something else. So he said, I don't know what's true anymore, which is Abby's
story.
Yeah,
it's so interesting because that goes into people's believability, like in the legal system. It's just so fascinating altogether. So now Niagara Falls, you know that Niagara Falls is kind of tacky. Were you aware?
No, I wasn't aware.
Are you disappointed?
No, I wasn't disappointed, actually, because Albert gave me some great books to read about the area before I went, which was kind of a real condensed but very thorough and weird history of the area. It wasn't like a tourist guide to it. It kind of tells you how the whole place came about, how this kind of huge commercial industry grew around this kind of natural wonder. And once you know the story of the history, it's... You kind of can't help but love it. There's something so charming about it in the way that it's unlike anywhere else.
It's not like Vegas.
No. But it's there's something Blackpool. Especially at it's kind of reminded me of Blackpool. At low season, it's kind of there are some amazing characters, and you get to see the city quite clearly without all of the tourists, without all of the bright lights. And I kind of enjoyed. Immersing myself in that. It was sort of bleak, but in a way that was really enjoyable.
But that's something about the film. It's bleak, but it's so magnetic.
Yeah.
So how what do you think that is?
Well, I think in large part it's due to the falls, the mystery of the falls. I mean, I would make a point to go down and walk by them every day. And you just, there's this really strong visceral pull towards them that it's like it becomes kind of, it's really enchanting.
Yeah.
And it's in this, yeah, this kind of it feels, there's like a weird insidious nature to it where you don't even realize it's happening, but you all of a sudden are aware that you want to like follow jump that fast in current down to the bottom.
Yes.
Which is so I mean, that's like an allegory for Abby's character. That's the way in which, you know, these people, these like sort of, you know, kind of, you could have nefarious underpinnings, but they're still so entrancing that you just want to follow them anyway, even if you know it might
you end up
be
on the rocks.
Yeah.
It's like,
great allegory. Thank you so much, ladies.
Thank you.
Thank you.